What makes Phelps Mill so unusual is that the structure is basically intact. The way you see it is the way it looked when it was built in 1889 and the addition put on a few years later. The vast majority of the original machinery is still intact. I mean, you go into Phelps Mill, it's like taking a step back in time. The owner of Phelps Mill, a man named William Thomas, he came from Bloomington, Wisconsin to work in the flour and feed business, and he worked in Fergus Falls until he purchased some acreage in Maine Township along the Otter Tail River. And he saw the rolling water, decided this would be a good place to construct a flour mill, which of course he began doing in 1885. And it opened in December of 1889. The name Phelps Mill comes from Ray Thomas's wife, Leona Phelps. Her maiden name was Phelps, so the town was called Phelps. The historic name of the mill when he opened it was the Maine Roller Mills. Maine for the township that we are in right now, and roller mills for the technology, the roller milling process. The mill was designed to produce 60 to 75 barrels of flour a day. Farmers from throughout the area would come with their wagons of wheat, and it got to the point where so many farmers would come to bring their wheat that they would have to wait, and so he built a kind of a bunkhouse called the Farmer's Roost, where farmers could spend the night while waiting to get their wheat ground. And then a few years later, the mill expanded and he built an addition, which is the red part of the mill where the red tin siding is. And that was designed to grind buckwheat and rye. And the mill continued with great success through the early part of the 20th century until it just became more and more difficult to compete with the great mills of Minneapolis and St. Paul. And it eventually closed. It was sold to a man in Underwood, H.G. Evenson, in 1928, and he operated it for a few years doing some feed grinding, and then it permanently closed the stores in 1939. Milling is a complicated process, but through the machinery that is in Phelps Mill, you are able to follow how wheat was turned into flour. Most rural flour mills, because of the dust of the milling process, had major fires and were burned to the ground. The fact that the Maine roller mills was able to survive those decades without a fire was totally amazing. The mill is wide open for the general public to walk around, so we are constantly worried about a stray cigarette or coming and the mill just, you know, going up into flames. We now have a security system in the mill, so especially in the winter when it's shut up, so there's no break-ins. We recently installed lightning rods on the mill, thanks to a legacy amendment grant to protect against fire. You know, we estimate at least 10 to 15,000 visitors come through during a season. The Phelps Mill Festival is held the second weekend of July as a major arts and crafts festival. Benefits a lot of local organizations, and it's the reason it is so popular, in my opinion, is in the background you have the historic flour mill. It is a pretty easy drive from Minneapolis, from Fargo. It's just off Otter Tail County Highway 45. There's also the Phelps Mill store, which is the original general store, and now they sell ice cream. A real popular place for people to visit. It just harkens back to a rural lifestyle and a time that is long gone.
This program is funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.